Welcome to Share My Lesson. In this video, I'm going to discuss the 2023 Junior Mathematical Challenge Solutions. The level of this exam is similar to the Australian Mathematics Competition Junior Division. Let's move on to the solutions. This is a simple subtraction. As you can see, 3,202 minus 2,023 is equal to 1,179. This means that the answer is C. Of the options given, only 4 is not a factor of 30. This means that 4 of the options are factors of 30, so the answer is D. The numerator adds up to 15 and the denominator adds up to 40. This gives a fraction 15 over 40, which can be simplified to 3 over 8. This means that the answer is B. Of the options given, 12 is divisible by 2, 24 is divisible by 8, and 36 is divisible by 18. However, 72 is not divisible by 14, and 96 is not divisible by 54. Since we are told that one of these is a larger two-digit number that is divisible by the product of its digits, 36 is that number. This means that the answer is C. Jumpy's speed is his distance, which is 100 meters, divided by his time. His time is 19.65 seconds, which is approximately equal to 20 seconds. So Jumpy's speed is 100 divided by 20, which is 5 meters per second. This means that the answer is E. We can fill in the blank circles with the letters A, B, C, D, and E. You can see in the diagram that 13 plus 23 plus A is equal to 43, which is a given total of each of the four sides. This means that A is equal to 43 minus 36, which is equal to 7.
We can get another question, which is C plus 29 plus D is equal to 43. This means that C plus D is equal to 14. So C and D are either equal to 3 and 11 or 11 and 3. Try the possibility if C is 3. This means that 3 plus B plus 13 is 43 and B is 27. However, 27 is not a prime number. This means that C has to be equal to 11. So 7 plus 19 plus 11 plus 3 plus 17 is equal to 57. This means that the answer is D.
The largest two-digit multiple of 2 is equal to 98, and the smallest three-digit multiple of 3 is equal to 102. The difference is 102 minus 98, which is equal to 4. This means that the answer is B. we can find the sums of each of these equations. The first one is 1, the next is 5, then 13, then 25, then 41, and finally 61. Out of these 6 numbers, only 4 are primes. This means that the answer is D. Since the triangle is an isosceles triangle, LM is equal to LN, and the angle LNM is equal to the angle LMN. This means that 3x minus 20 is equal to 2x plus 8, so x is equal to 28 degrees. Since we know that the angle sum of a triangle is equal to 180 degrees, we can write an equation using the values of all the different angles. We get 4y plus 5x minus 20 is equal to 180. So 4y is equal to 200 minus 5x. We know that x is equal to 28 degrees. So 4y is equal to 200 minus 5 multiplied by 28. So y is equal to 60 divided by 4, which is 15. This means the answer is A. Even though in the diagram, a section has been cut off, there's no difference to the perimeter it would have had if it was a complete rectangle. We can write an equation, which is 2x plus 18 plus 18, which is equal to 60, which is the given perimeter of the shape. This means that x is equal to 60 minus 36 divided by 2, which is 12. So the total area is equal to 18 minus 12, which is a full rectangle, minus the cut-off section, which is 24. This is equal to 216 minus 24, which is equal to 192. This means that the answer is A. Since 120 is a multiple of 4, Scrooge is able to use all of the tea bags when he uses 2 dry tea bags per cup and when he uses 4 dry tea bags per cup. The required number of decent cups of tea is, in the first round, 120 plus the second round, which is 120 divided by 2, which is 60, plus the third round, which is 120 divided by 4, which is 30. This gives us 120 plus 60 plus 30, which is 210. This means that the answer is C. In the 20 minutes between 1:50 p.m. and 2:10 p.m, Brian slithered a total of 210 minus 150, which is 60 centimeters. So Brian slithered at a rate of 3 centimeters per minute, and therefore he took 50 minutes to slither 150 centimeters. This means that Brian started at 1:50 minus 50 minutes, which is 1 p.m. This means that the answer is E. One side of the square is equal to 8 centimeters because the area of the square is equal to 64 centimeters squared. We can mark x and y as per the diagram. We know that x plus y is equal to 8, and the perimeter of one rectangle equal to x plus y plus y. which is equal to 2 multiplied by x plus y. We know that x plus y is equal to 8, so this is equal to 2 multiplied by 8, which is 16 centimeters. This means that the answer is D. The three values of x can either add up to 17 or 27. However, 17 is not divisible by 3. This means that 3x is equal to 27, so x is equal to 9. We move on to the tens digit. We get an equation where 2, which is a carry on from the units digit, plus 7 plus 2y is either equal to 19 or 29. This means that 2y is either equal to 10 or 20, and y is either equal to 5 or 10. However, x and y represents different single digits, so 10 would not work. This means that y is equal to 5, and x plus y is equal to 9 plus 5, which is 14. This means that the answer is E. A regular journey would have started at 17:48 and would have ended at 18:25, taking a total of 37 minutes. However, he arrived 4 minutes late, so the train left at 17:52 and took twice as long, which is an extra 74 minutes. This is equal to 18:52 plus 14, which is 1906. This means that the answer is B. We know that the first two digits and the last two digits each make up a two-digit number, which is a multiple of 11. Every two-digit number, which is a multiple of 11, has each of its digit the same. This means that the four-digit PIN is equal to A, A, B, B. We also know that the sum of all the digits is a multiple of 11. This means that A plus A plus B plus B is equal to N multiplied by 11, where N multiplied by 11 is any multiple of 11. We can simplify this to get A plus B is equal to N multiplied by 11 over 2. The maximum possible value of A plus B is equal to 18, where A and B are both 9. The only multiple of 11 that is less than 18 is 11. This means that A plus B is equal to 11. We can write down each of the possible values of both A and B. These are 2, 9, 3, 8, 4, 7, 5, and 6. This is a total of 4 values. However, we can reverse them, so we have to multiply this by 2, which gives us a total of 8. This means that the answer is D. We know that 0 is less than P, which is less than Q, which is less than 1. This means that Q minus P is less than Q, which is less than 1, and P minus Q is less than 0, and P plus Q divided by 2 is less than 1 plus 1 divided by 2, which is 1. This gives that P over Q is less than 1, and Q over P is greater than 1. So Q over P is the only one of the 5 expressions which is greater than 1, which means that it is the largest. This means that the answer is E. We can mark the 4 shaded angles as A, B, C, and D. We can then mark the interior angles of the quadrilateral as 180 minus A, 360 minus B, 180 minus C, and 180 minus D. This means that the sum of the angles of this quadrilateral is 180 minus A plus 360 minus B plus 180 minus C plus 180 minus D, which is equal to the sum of the interior angles for quadrilateral, which is 360. We can simplify this to get 540 minus A minus B minus C minus D is equal to 0, which gives us that A plus B plus C plus D is equal to 540. This means that the answer is A. If the Rangers did not score in the first half, then there would be a total of 5 possible halftime scores from 0-0 to 0-4. However, if the Rangers scored 1 goal in the first half, then there would be a total of 4 possible halftime scores, from 1-0 to 1-4. In a similar way, we can find out that there is a total of 3 possible halftime scores if the Rangers scored 2 goals in the first half, but the 2 possible halftime scores if the Rangers scored 3 goals in the first half, and 1 possible halftime score if the Rangers scored 4 goals in the first half. It is also possible that all the goals were scored in the first half and that the halftime score was 5-4. So the total possible number of halftime scores is 16. This question gives a cross number. Usually, we have to solve cross numbers by trying out the different possibilities. For example, if 1 across is a 2-digit cube, this means that it is 27 or 64. Also, 2 across is a 2-digit square, which means that it's either 16, 25, 36, 49, 64, or 81. Meaning that 1 down has to end in a 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, or 8. If a 1 across is 27, then the possibilities for 1 down are 21, 22, 23, 24, 26, and 28. Of these, only 23 is a prime. In a similar way, if 1 across is 64, then the possibilities for 1 down are 61, 62, 63, 64, 66, and 68. Of these, only 61 is a prime. So the two possibilities are that 1 across is 27, 1 down is 23, and 2 across is 36, or that 1 across is 64. 1 down is 61, and 2 across is 16. So the sum of the 4 digits in the cross number is 2, plus 7 plus 3 plus 6, which is 18, or 6 plus 1 plus 6, which is 17. Of these two possibilities, only 17 is one of the options. This means that the answer is A. Mm.
G is the amount of grey elephants. P is the amount of pygmy elephants. W is the amount of white elephants. And K is the amount of pink elephants. Based on the given information, we can write four equations, which are G is equal to 2P, and W is equal to 3G, and K is equal to 4W, and W minus P is equal to 20. We can mark the first three equations with the numbers 1, 2, and 3. Using the equation W minus P is equal to 20, and using our second equation, which is W is equal to 3G, we can get another equation, which is 3G minus P is equal to 20. This is equivalent to 6G minus 2P is equal to 40. Using our very first equation, we get that 6G minus G is equal to 40, so 5G is equal to 40, and G is equal to 8. Substituting this value into our first equation, we get that P is equal to 4, which means that W is equal to 24 and K is equal to 96. We can add these up to get 96 plus 24 plus 8 plus 4 to get a total of 132 elephants. This means that the answer is B. First, we have to find the three numbers that multiply to 18. These are 1 multiplied by 9 multiplied by 2, or 1 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 6. This means that 9 is either in the middle square of the first row, or it's in the third square of the first row. It cannot be in the first square, since 9 is not a factor of 56. Try the possibility if 9 is in the last square of the first row. We can fill it out with 9, 1, and 4, as these are the factors of 36 that work. However, when we look at the second row, the two squares have to multiply to 105. However, they are not two single-digit numbers that have a product of 105. This means that this possibility does not work. Try the combination if 9 is in the middle square of the first row. We can fill in the top column with 1, 9, and 2. We can then fill in the remaining squares of the first column with 7 and 8. It has to be in that order, because 8 is not a factor of 105. We can then fill in the remaining two squares of the second row with 5 and 3, because 36 does not have 5 as its factors. This means that the middle square of the second column is 4, because 9 multiplied by 5 multiplied by 4 is a product of 180, and the question mark is 6, because 2 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 6 is 36. The number in the bottom right hand cell is 6. This means that the answer is B. The line PH is perpendicular to the line RS. This means that the angle OHS is 90 degrees. As per the given information that each of the angles at O are equal, this means that each of them are 60 degrees, since they all add up to 360. Take the quadrilateral OGSH. Each of the angles of the pentagon is 5 minus 2 multiplied by 180 divided by 5, which is 108. The angle sum of a quadrilateral is 360 degrees. Using this information, we can find the angle OGS, which is 360, minus the three remaining angles, which is 60, plus 108, plus 90, which is 102. The angle sum of a straight line is 180 degrees. This means that the angle TGO is equal to 180 minus 102, which is 78 degrees. This means that the answer is E. It's important to consider that when the paper means on her birthday this year, the paper is referring to the date in which the paper was made, which is 2023. We can solve this question by trying out the different years in which she could be born. Try 2000. The digits add up to 2, and in 2023, she'd be 23 years old. Try 2001. The digits add up to 3, and in 2023, she'd be 22 years old. Try 2002. The digits add up to 4, and in 2023, she'd be 21. Similarly, we can try out the other possibilities. Soon, we find out that 2015 works. Now, we can try out the answers. 2027 minus 2015 is 12, and 2 plus 2 plus 7 is 11, and 11 plus 2 is equal to 22. However, 22 is not equal to 12. In a similar way, we can try out the different possibilities or the answers. Try 2035. 2035 minus 2015 is 20, 2 plus 3 plus 5 is 10, and 10 multiplied by 2 is 20. This works. This means that the answer is E. Let the number of spoons which Granny's neighbour received be n. Since the neighbour's share completes the distribution of all of Granny's spoons, n is also the number of spoons which were left after the son's share was removed. This means that n is equal to n over 3 plus 8, which means that 2n over 3 is equal to 8, and n is equal to 12. Let the number of spoons remaining after Granny's daughter had taken a share of spoons be y. So Granny's son, or S, received y over 3 plus 8 spoons, and then there were 12 spoons remaining, which means that y over 3 plus 8 is equal to y minus 12. Therefore, 2y over 3 is equal to 20, and y is equal to 30. Let the number of spoons in Granny's collection be x. Then Granny's daughter, or D, received a total of x over 3 plus 8 spoons, and then there were 30 spoons remaining. This means that x over 3 plus 8 is equal to x minus 30. This means that 2x over 3 is 38, and x is 57. 5 plus 7 is 12. This means that the answer is B. We have now completed the 2023 UKMT Junior Mathematical Challenge. Thank you for watching, and make sure to subscribe and check out my blog for more videos.